check it out.
Check what out?
Yo, check this out.
Good, man, I'm good. Nah, I was born in Queens.
Okay, you're
born in
Queens.
You know what I mean? But I'm like the first person in my family actually born in New York, you know what I'm saying? So the whole family, yeah, the whole family, dad, moms, both from Trinidad, you know what I'm saying? I have a couple family members from Barbados or whatever, through marriage, of course, but for the most part, it's TNT all the way.
Trini Gladiator, anti-hesitator, Shahid push the Vader, from here to Grenada, Mr. Energetic, who me sound pathetic, when's the last time you heard a funky diabetic?
You know, me and Tip, Jarobi, Ali, you know, we were just doing our thing because we love to do it. It's like when I said to Tip one time when Jam Master Jay first passed away, I was letting them know. I was like, yo, man, it's like when them dudes were doing their thing, because I'm from St. Albans, like, which is like right here. And they're from Hollis, which is probably right here. You know what I mean? So growing up in Queens, those were our idols. Those were the gods for us. Mm-hmm. So coming up, everybody nowadays, everybody has their own little cadences, their own style, their own flow. You know what I'm saying? They have something about them that you can nitpick and say, this is them. You know what I'm saying? Back then, coming up, we didn't care about none of that. We wanted to be them.
I like them brown, yellow, Puerto Rican, and Haitian. Name is Phife Dawg from the Zulu Nation. Told you in the jam that we could get down. Now let's knock the boots like the group H-Town.
Boils down to you just gotta be yourself. Don't try too hard, cause that's when they really notice. Like you go to a London, or you go to an Amsterdam, or some place like that. That's when they really can read through you. When you show your not so true colors, you know what I'm saying? That's when they can read you. But if you have a way of doing things in Toronto, as far as keeping it real, keep it real like that. Keep it Toronto. Don't go to Montreal and try to switch that up. You know what I'm saying? Cause Montreal's gonna be like, dude is fronting like this. You know what I'm saying? So it just boils down to being yourself at the end of the day.
Damn, Tip, what did you drive so far for?
Well, describe to me what the wallet looks like.
Learn the game, for one, how it's ran out here. But if you're not comfortable with it, you could always go back to being yourself. That's the good thing about it, you know what I'm saying? It's all about your dignity at the end of the day. You gotta be you, man. So I'm Trinidadian, it's like, I'll never change that. You know what I'm saying? I just had some Pelori, you know what I'm saying? That's the one thing I like about Toronto, because it's such a hotbed of people. Like, you go through one block, it's mad Brazilian. Go through another block, Portuguese, you know what I'm saying? Go through another block, it's Trinidadians or maybe Jamaicans or whatever. I'll never change me, man. I could go to the next block, but they going to know I'm Trini. You know what I'm saying? Not in an ignorant or a malicious way, but this is what I stand for. This is me. I'm from New York. I'm not going to try to be Pharrell, who's from Virginia Beach. You understand what I'm saying? But I'm going to show love, though. You know what I'm saying? And learn everything I can learn from him and whoever else is out there doing their thing.
Hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Hey, sucker nigga. Hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are.
Get his ass whooped. I mean, it's that simple. You know what I'm saying? I don't care how it's used, how it's said. That's not for you to be saying. You know what I'm saying? Like Q-Tip said on the Stopping Man. We, as black people, we tend to use it as a term of endearment. And don't get me wrong, a lot of folks, a lot of black folks still hate that. You know what I'm saying? Due to what their ancestors went through and things of that nature. A lot of us still hate that word. But I could say that to Q-Tip. He could say it to me. I'm not gonna feel no way. It's like, yeah, I it's nothing. But if Vanilla Ice was standing there, it was like, yo, what up? He getting his ass. You have to know where to draw the line. And a lot of people, They get so comfortable, they don't know where that line is exactly. It just boils down to being yourself at the end of the day.
Yo, microphone check, 1, 2, what is this? The 5 foot assassin with the roughneck business. I float like gravity, never had a cavity. Got more rhymes than the one that's got family. No need to sweat Arsenio to gain some type of fame. No shame in my game, cause I always be the same. Styles upon styles upon styles is what I have. You wanna just the Phife, but you still don't know the half.
I think my Eagles won today.
Ah.
So I'm gonna tell you right now. I'm gonna tell you right. Oh, damn it. It's going into overtime.
Oh, you lost so much?
No. But it's going into overtime. So what I was gonna say was, okay, now that feeling is like, if they'd have won, I'd have been like, now that it's going into overtime, my feeling is like, you know what I'm saying?